Welcome to Arts Midwest World Fest. Since 2003, we've brought international musicians to communities throughout the Midwest. This year, when we can't be with you in person, we're still bringing music and culture from around the world to your screens. Think global, hear it local, with World Fest.
Thank you very much. We are so glad to be with you. I am Hadar Maoz, and this is my special ensemble. And we lived in a very special place called Israel. And Israel is a small country in the Middle East. Small country in terms of geographic space. But the roots of Israel are very, very ancient. Almost all the stories from the Bible happen in Israel. And Israel is the place that Jesus, King David, and another biblical hero lived. But before 2,000 years, the people of Israel, the Jewish people, are exiled from the homeland. But before 100 years, the Jewish people from all over the world came back to Israel and established the new land of Israel once again. And my family came back to Israel from Persia and Bukhara. It's in Central Asia. And they are bringing with them a beautiful, beautiful culture and music. My grandmother, who was a Persian, Bukharian singer and musician, taught me this kind of devotional singing and music when I was little. And the first song we just opened with, called Gule Sangam, it is a Persian love song, which I learned from my grandmother. And I play this song with this beautiful instrument called the doira drum. My grandmother was a big master on this instrument. And this is the drum that's famous all over Central Asia. And look, we have here a beautiful technique of drumming that, unlike a real drum, this drum is held up in the air like that. And behind the drum, there are rings that accompany the palms who are drumming. So when I play, we have the illusion of two people playing together at the same time. One is playing with the palms, while the another is keeping the rhythm straight with the rings. Come on, look. And that was the Persian traditional rhythm called Jivoni. And we want to teach you this rhythm by clapping your hand. So, come on. In your country, the basic rhythm will be like that. Look. Please clap your hands with us. Please, come on, come on. But in our country, in the Middle East, the rhythm will be like that. Please, clap your hands with us. Come on, come on. So that was the Persian rhythm called Jivoni. And for this kind of rhythm, we have a traditional dance. So look. This is the traditional costume we are dancing with. It's the Jewish traditional costume. Teach you a few dance movements. So the first one will be the neck movement. Watch and repeat after me. Yak du se cho. Come on, children, come on. Yak du se cho. And the second one will be the shoulder movement. Watch and repeat after me. Jak du se cho. Jak du se cho. And the last one will be the hands movement. Watch and repeat after me. Jak du se cho. Thank you very much. Roy, please.
Okay, hello everybody. Very nice to meet you. I'm very excited to be here. You see, I was born and raised in a very small Bay Area city called Haifa in Israel. Growing up, I took up an instrument called baglama or saz, which is the Turkish uncle of the tar that Hadar plays. After playing this instrument for a couple of years, I took up the oud that Marina plays. All through this time, growing up as a teenager, I was also playing the guitar. And throughout my teenager years, I tried to combine the style of playing with the saz and the tar and the oud, these kind of sounds, the Eastern sounds, and try to incorporate them into the guitar playing. So now I will play for you a special small melody that combines both of the styles, the Western and the Eastern. Here we go.
Hi everybody, my name is Itamar and I play percussions. I've studied music on a variety of instruments ever since I was 5 years old, and I play Buharian and Persian rhythms for about 8 or 9 years now. And I play them on a wide variety of drums from all around the world that I've put in together especially for this show. You can see that I'm using ethnic finger techniques such as these. And I combine them with modern drumming on the set with the drums from around the world. I have here the cajon from Peru. The African djembe. The Middle Eastern darbuka. And the hi-hat cymbals and the snare drum, born in America 100 years ago. I will play something for you now, and I want you to please help me by clapping like this. Yeah, everybody, join me. Come on, hold the beat. Continue. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Marina. I'm oud player. This is oud. This is very, very old string instrument. And its roots are in Central Asia. I think that this instrument is maybe 3,000 years old. We play this instrument with a pick called risha. It's a long pick. Let me tell you a story about oud. Once upon a time, maybe 1,000 years ago, there was a boy called Ziryab. He lived in Central Asia, and he was very, very accomplished oud player. His teacher was a very famous musician, and his name was Isaac El-Musili. One day, a boy, Ziryab, sat in a garden, and he played his beautiful instrument. And suddenly, the king, Harun al-Rashid, passed by, and he heard the beautiful sounds of a boy's instrument. He came to the boy and said, "Oh, this is so beautiful. I would like you to have a concert in my court." And Ziryab was so proud of himself, and he told to his teacher, "I am going to have a concert for the king." Of course, Isaac El-Musili was very happy for his student and wished him really the best of luck. After the concert, that was a real success, the teacher, Isaac El-Musili, told to Ziryab, "Please, take your instrument and your music and go to the West, to the Europe, and show to the people what you can do with your beautiful instrument." So, this is what happened. Ziryab went to Spain. In Spain, he established a music school, and until now, we play the same instrument as he did, and actually we have the same tuning, and we play also the same tunes. Now I'm gonna play for you a small improvisation called Takasim, and afterward, one of the very famous songs in Israel called Fok El Nahar.
Ancient Persian guitar. It has a long neck and seven strings. And the roots of this instrument are 3,000 years old. It is an instrument that was played at the Persian King Palace. It also played in the Second Temple in Jerusalem, where Jesus preached. So these stories, two stories, give me the inspiration to write my next composition, Ancient Melody.